This presentation is talking about the Gustavo Becerra thought, in particular the idea of Gustavo Becerra published in reviews, press, magazines, academic magazines, and magazine for the common people. This presentation. In 1972, the Chilean composer Domingo Santa Cruz wrote in the Chilean music magazine, "Gustavo Becerra, a musician of his time." This writing was a sober tribute to the new National Prize of Music, who had been his student, assistant, and finally, who replaced him in many tasks within the University of Chile. Santa Cruz stated that Becerra catalyzed, through his action and his work, the current of his time. In this sense, the avant-garde, the political commitment, especially a relationship that linked him to his Chilean and Latin American context and his music. 10 years before, in 1960, Domingo Santa Cruz wrote about an uncomfortable political event at the University of Chile. In the same magazine, he said, "Mr. Becerra, today protests something that as a composer he should have been supported, because the center of gravity of the musical life, unless we manage to rectify it, is not where it used to be or where it should be in music. It is to this that my observations are directed, not to the people or interests, but to the art." These two episodes of life between Santa Cruz and Becerra show a profound cultural and political change in the musical life of Chile. The composer, in the judgment of the conservative Santa Cruz, forgot the art and put new interest in the musical activity. This episode helped us to start my presentation. I want to comment the relationship between musical thought and the ideological and social context in the 60s in particular. We must remember that the Chilean left in the 1956 created a new conglomerate called FRAP. The FRAP, from of Popular Action, which again grouped the Marxist parties with the other center-left parties like radical parties and democratic parties. This agenda included reform to the economy and private property. This generated great support in the middle sector, like professional, worker, student, and intellectual. This political rhetoric of FRAP included a renewed vision of the concept of nation and Latin America, clearly influenced by the result of the Cuban Revolution. New actors and new agents come into play. Music was no left of these problems. Gustavo Becerra was part of the generation of composers who changed the paradigm of the composition in Chile. Becerra carried out an important task, theorizing about the new way of creating music, associated with the reason, logic, the expression, literature, and cultural context of the composer. The article of "Crisis in the Teaching of Composition in West" in 1958 and 1959 were an important and theoretical contribution to the composition debate in Chile. In the same year, Musical Chilean magazine also published "A Stylistic Problem of the Young Composer in Latin America and Chile" by Roberto Falabella. At the end of the decade of the 50s, the new generation of musicians in the Faculty of Art of the Universidad de Chile questioned the role of the music in the Latin American context, using the same way of their teachers, classroom, publication, essay, and comment in the Chilean music magazine. Before proceeding, we must emphasize the Chilean composer was the one who gave shape to the music institution. Since 1927, his work as a university academic put him in the field of humanity and arts, bureaucratic administration, and finally the power, political power. The Chilean composer was an active agent of the modernizing cultural politics. The modern Chilean state needed music for an aesthetic and artistic correlate. Domingo Santa Cruz, Pedro Humberto Allende, René Amengual, and others create the culture of Chilean music. This important composer not only create musical work, they also generate space, institution, and funding, such as the Musical Extension Institute of the University of Chile, the Symphony Orchestra of Chile, and the Chilean Musical Magazine. This publication was the medium in which a narrative of academic music was created. The duty of a composer in the 50s was not only the teaching works and composition, it was also the publication of comment, essays, and analysis of the work premiered at the music festival and other instances. The Chilean composer was an intellectual before becoming a Latin American intellectual. Gustavo Becerra take this tradition, created by his teacher, and used it to not only comment. Now the composer left his autonomy and deliberate on the need for a new music. It's a new music for a new policy. In Becerra's work, we find the tradition of the French popular front in the 20s, as well the ideal of Sartre and Gramsci, where the artist embodied the ideology and his life in his lives and works, transforming himself into a reference for a public and object of political admiration. But the contract between music and ideology, music and politics, was not easy. The aesthetic demand of Latin American composition and the European referent put finally the question, how can we be avant-garde in art and society? This question defined a space that Becerra used better than anyone else. In 1958, Becerra says, until now the academy offered little or nothing to real expressive problem, reducing the invention to the only possibility of finding new objective structure, leading to discover and not express. The quality of the language of music disappears. Becerra criticisms of the style and constraint that operate in the Chilean composition had made it unrelate to the cultural context. From this moment, the problem music and society, music and politics, is installed as part of the concert of the Chilean Academy. But from the time of the Bach Society, de la Sociedad Bach, in the 20s, the opinions as to Alfonso Leng on the popular music or Italian music were part of the Chilean composition life. The aesthetic musical debate between the 20s and the 60s was defined by the distance of the modern music and the other music, like popular music, folk, entertainment music, and others. The relationship between society, high and low culture, and academic music was a leitmotiv, in my opinion, until now. It is for this reason that the musical aesthetic in Chile was evaluated and defined from the musical elite, from the university. The narrative around musical institution and composer generate a discourse that ordered and designed a space for musical action. Modern music in Chile was political before of the left movement reached the political scene in the 60s. The composer from the Chilean Music Magazine carried out an intellectual political work that defined music and the way of production and consumption, like the value of the classical style, modern music, the rejection of the socialist realms, and the adoption of the autonomous music. Chilean Music Festival, created in 1948, are especially valuable at moments and link between musical art and society. Finally, the Chilean music was very disciplined by the opinion of the composer previously named. This work is a central fact to understand that Chilean composer had, since the creation of the Faculty of Art of the Universidad de Chile, an active role in the formation of the modern experience music in our country. The publication of article Crisis of the Teaching of the Composition in the West marked the beginning of the sustained work by Gustavo Serra to change the role of the music in society in Chile, America, and even in Spain. 1962, Becerra published in Spanish magazine Ritmo, says, it is postulated, therefore, the unification of the musical language so that the popular and the classic, or the popular or the own of the elite of the present, only differ in the greater or lesser extended associative elaboration of the context, elaborate on the basis of rule and precept. The denial of the duality between classical and popular music was the first step toward the creation of a new conception of music in Chile. At this time, Becerra opened the Taller 44, where he taught composition to students outside of academy, including Luis Albi, Sergio Ortega, Fernando Garcia, Miguel Letelier, and others. The result of experience was the improvement in the production of the popular music, the new Chilean song, always Becerra the formation of his most important musician. The relationship between intellectual activity and music in Latin America is typical of the 20th century. The Argentine historian Claudio Gilman said that the Latin American intellectual used their works, culture, and industry, and magazine to carry out a criticism that entails a shame to culture. Gustavo Serra not only criticized music, criticized the music culture or cultural music and the structure in which it developed. From this moment, the composer begins to develop work that are inserted in the avant-garde and the other text element of popular music. The use of the avant-garde element and tonal element show us that Becerra sought to express the new role of the composer, in which the categories of the music were secondary to the social role of the music. This role was to free Latin America from American influence and establish a culture outside of imperialism. The role of art and academies was to help liberate societies from the capitalist ideology. A musical example of this is Canciones de Alta Copa, with lyrics by the poet Andrés Sabella. Becerra and Sabella are communists. The party brought together a large number of intellectuals who helped change the art culture in Chile. Help us. La audición.
Oh, patrono de las viñas, San Vicente viñatero, santo del santo guarguero, en sed de mostos y vinos. Aunque nacieras en Huesca y te matara un romano, eres de todos hermano por tu clara sangre fresca.
Thank you.
vacío. Soñaba un parrón de luces con las uvas color frío. Los hijos desesperados mojaban su vieja frente. Echaba el malo sus dados, riéndole un solo diente. Las arpas y las guitarras conversaban a destajo, mientras la luna en las tardas venía paso y refajo. Alguna china en camisa mostraba lo que mostraba la noche, manta de risa de charco en charco saltaba. Ay, damas y damajuanas, don y dones de esta turca, a Noé salieron canas con vaivenes de mazurca. ¡Viva esta agüita morada! Clamaba Yuyo el patriarca. La historia no cuenta nada, ni del precio ni la marca. Los cufifos y bolseros pedían cueca y pequeñes. Aún los carabineros no fundaban sus retenes. Noé temblaba de azoro. ¿Dónde estoy por la chupalla? Le aconsejó un roto choro. Plántele a Dios una falla. Consuelo de patriota, come lo más, no vacile, páguese luego otra bota, estamos parreando en Chile, estamos parreando en Chile.
Until this moment, Becerra was created only neoclassical music. From this moment, Becerra created an important relation with Pablo Neruda and Pablo Neruda's poems. The works of this relation are Peleas en Melisande, Peleas y Melisande, No me lo pidan, Oratorio Machu Picchu, El Deseo, Lord Cochrane de Chile, Oda al Alambre de Púas, Cuatro Canciones, Agua Dormida, Los Sátrapas, Chile 1973, América, y Oratorio para Servirte de Vueltas, y Que Despierte el Leñador. This work proposed the relationship between the avant-garde and political commitment, but they also suppose a model in which musical autonomy is relegated to second plane in the composition. Once the Pinochet dictatorship arrived, Becerra manifested his resistance through his music directly. Chile 1973, Corbalán and the Cantatas Allende, among the other works, showed how music had become part of the culture of the Chilean left. At the same time that Becerra related musical texts, poetic texts, and music, he wrote about the philosophical and political problem of music. Edward Said says about the intellectual, "For me, the decisive fact in the intellectual is an individual endowed with the power to represent, embody, and articulate a message, a vision, an attitude, a philosophy, or an opinion for and in favor of your audience." Because of this, Becerra wrote about beauty in music, about mass media, cultural industry, and the role of the audience, themes that were constantly repeated in his writings and interviews. His critical opinion was committed to the libertarian idea of the music and its conception. Becerra says, "Let us the particular and see the field, something more general of the instruction of the average musician. In general, it ignored the most elementary of aesthetic, cultural anthropology, sociology, psychology, economics, and politics. Do not overdo it. let's leave here this tragic enumeration. The musician is, in general, a being disconnected from the world that surrounds him. In this sense, Becerra realized that the mass media are more important than the concert hall, that the musical world without this mass media is located in itself. In the Araucaria magazine in the 70s, Chilean literature and Chilean music magazine in the 80s, the author expressed his interest in the diffusion of the music and industry. Music for Becerra is not a product of a personal or isolated interest. It's a product of a cultural one. It's a critical interpretation of the world. It is art, the discourse from which, in first place, politics can be made. Non-political music does not exist in Becerra's ideas. Behind the sound, there is a conception of the world. It's a cultural conception for which no music is pure. Becerra understood that even a sonata is committed to a way of a living and ordering music and the society. Perhaps the word that best expresses its political conception is revolution. This word, writing for Quilapayún, is political message in the musical appointment and not in the narrative text, only contain the word revolution, but the music used cues for the Marsellesa, the international, the communist anthem, the Chilean anthem, and Venceremos. Let's hear revolution.
Revolución, revolución, revolución. Revolución, revolución, revolución. Revolución, revolución, revolución. Revolución, revolución, revolución. Revolución, 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 revolución.
Revolución,
revolución. Revolución, 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 revolución,
The conclusion. The critics that Gustavo Becerra expressed throughout his life and musical work, writing and interviews, reveal the canon of the Chilean academic music has changed little. Popular music is still viewed with distrust as well as every element of industry. Will we still trust premiere in concert hall with little public? Today, we cannot blame the cultural regime of Pinochet. Today, we train composer and musical performer who must know the importance of the art and music in society, which is not only a reflection. Music shapes society, change it. Not believing in this world be to deny the legacy of Gustavo Becerra's thought. In the last interview in Revista Musical Chilena, he says, instead saying, so much no, 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 let's say yes, yes, yes. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Pablo. A nice piece also. And we're going to open right now the round of questions. I see a few hands there. So where was the microphone? Who has the microphone? There it is, please.
Thank you for your paper, it was really interesting. I want to ask you, what do you think, or if you can explain a bit more about what Becerra said, that all music is political, not just the left music is political, and what he meant about that, and what do you think about that? If you can explain it a bit more.
Autonomous music. Perdón, en castellano por ahí.
Bueno.
La música autónoma en Chile funciona.
The autonomous music in Chile functions.
Como una propaganda del orden democrático inaugurado el 39.
As a democratic order propaganda that was started in 1939.
It's modern music for the modern state. Becerra vio la, yo diría la imposibilidad de que la música siguiera ese camino dadas las presiones de la sociedad.
So Becerra saw this, it was impossible that, for music to follow this path because of the society that we had.
En ese momento aparecen actores del sistema democrático que no existían antes.
In that moment we had new figures of the democratic system.
Mujeres,
women,
campesinos,
farmers,
esencialmente. Por lo tanto, cuando Becerra escribe el 58, su artículo,
when Becerra writes his article in 1958.
Ve que la autonomía de la música que él practicó.
He sees that the music autonomy that he was he practiced.
No tiene contingencia social.
It's not has nothing to do with the society somehow.
Pero es relevante decirlo porque Becerra fue becado 2 años antes del 56.
Becerra had a scholarship in the 56.
Por Ibáñez, por Carlos Ibáñez del Campo.
By Carlos Ibáñez del Campo.
El mismo que creó la Facultad de Artes.
The same that created the Faculty of Arts in the University.
Fue becado en un viaje a Europa para transformarse tal vez en el gran compositor de la música autónoma.
He was given this scholarship to travel to Europe and to become the most important composers of the autonomous music.
Y se dio cuenta en Europa que su oficio, lo que le habían enseñado y la práctica que él hacía de la composición no le pertenecía.
And he got to know in Europe that this practice wasn't something from him.
Y es por eso que él cambia drásticamente su relación con la composición y con el mundo de lo que nosotros llamamos lo popular.
Because of this experience in Europe, he changes radically his view of his composition and of popular music.
Hay una obra en particular que es una ironía en el fondo. El tercer cuarteto de cuerdas de Becerra se llama Desde el Viejo Mundo o Del Viejo Mundo. Y en él practica irónicamente todo lo que se espera de un compositor académico.
Yeah, so Becerra has his third string quartet is like an irony because he puts in this piece almost all of what he thought the public is expecting from a proper composer. Another question? I had something very similar to your question before, and it has to do with politics in Chile because, okay, you told us that he meant that it's political, not in the sense that we used to know it, like in the left side of politics in Chile. but do you think that we can find politics in music without text? And if yes, in what sense? Where do we find this? Or how?
Es un problema filosófico.
It's a philosophical problem.
La música autónoma.
Autonomous music.
Se basa en una premisa, en un principio.
It bases itself in a principle.
Que es la libertad del hombre.
And that is the freedom of man.
Y como en el siglo XX.
In the 20th century.
De la libertad.
Freedom.
Fue un principio que las guerras mundiales finalmente instauraron para las democracias.
So in the 20th century, the different world wars established this freedom of men as a principle for democratic orders.
Es por esto que la música moderna y la búsqueda personal es sinónimo de libertad.
That's because that's the reason why modern music is an example or an expression of the search for this freedom.
Así una sonata, la sonata número uno o el cuarteto número uno es una expresión política de una idea de libertad.
So the first sonata or the first quartet is a political expression of this idea of freedom. Mm-hmm. Wanted to add something?
Question. So, from what one can see from this slide, one can see that he's sort of going into exile. He was still writing music as a Chilean composer in exile, like following what he was doing. So, how do you think it affected him going to live in Germany at the end and doing his last decades in Germany and writing music in that old world that he tried to confront in the late 50s, in the 60s and 70s. So how did that change him, or how did it affect him? Did he always was still like a Chilean composer in exile, or did he also change from being in Germany and trying to go to?
hay dos puntos que mencionar en ese sentido.
I have two points to mention.
El primero es que efectivamente el exilio generó que la música se transformara en un bastión de resistencia.
The first of these points is that to be in exile meant that the music was a way of defending himself, to resist against political situation.
Y el segundo es que en la medida que pasaban los años, Becerra se incorporó a los problemas políticos alemanes. Pero eso no significó que él volviera a una noción autónoma de la música.
The second point is that he started relating to political problems in Germany after a while, but that was not related to coming back to this autonomous music idea.
De hecho, tal vez la obra más importante de Becerra del periodo alemán es un oratorio que se llama Ossietzky, el oratorio Ossietzky.
Maybe one of the most important pieces of Becerra that he wrote during his stay in Germany was the Oratorio Ossietzky.
Además, Becerra, dado el contacto que tuvo con el primer mundo, finalmente con el capitalismo, incorporó más aún elementos de la industria. Un ejemplo es que escribió para banda de rock, por ejemplo.
As Becerra went more or had more contact with capitalism, he included in his repertoire pieces for rock bands. Another question, please.
Thanks for this. It's interesting and quite connected with what we talked before. I know that Becerra was an active member of the Communist Party, so I would like to ask you if you can expand more and on what is the position of Becerra in terms of politics during the 60s and until the coup d'etat, in terms of how this political avant-garde is related to the music avant-garde. That is something that also emerged yesterday.
Bueno, en primer lugar, el comunismo latinoamericano, en particular el chileno, tuvo una recepción tibia del realismo, una recepción.
Latin American communism and especially Chilean communism had not a really strong reception of idealism. Realism, sorry.
Sí, del realismo. En ese sentido, la experiencia chilena se puede citar como una manera alternativa a lo que los grandes bloques, China, Unión Soviética, o inclusive la experiencia francesa, podían dar en el tema del arte. ¿A qué voy con esto? La nueva canción chilena, Gustavo Becerra y otros compositores, crearon una manera inédita de consensuar la segunda vía, ¿verdad? El socialismo y el arte.
So Becerra and colleagues from him, they managed to build a connection between these two politic movements and do it through art, through music.
Es más, eso no significó que estuvieran ajenos a la discusión.
That did not mean that they were not involved in the discussion.
Hubo asistencia a congresos de Praga, ¿verdad? A todos los congresos en el fondo europeos de la izquierda, pero no se adhirió a las directrices de ellos.
He was informed and participating a little in the different parts of the world, but he wasn't really committed legally or officially.
Por lo tanto, no podríamos plantear que en Chile se practicó un arte socialista tradicional, ¿verdad? Sino que realmente es una experiencia bastante particular.
So we cannot say that in Chile there were there was in this time a movement constituted like politically connected. It was more an special case, the one of Becerra.
¿Y qué tiene de especial que pudo conciliar, y es por esto de lo vanguardista, pudo conciliar la libertad propia de una democracia y el compromiso de la izquierda revolucionaria?
So he managed to combine the search for freedom and this feeling of belonging to a revolutionary movement of the left. Okay, we will move on then. Thank you very much, Pablo, again.
Thanks.